Hi there, thanks for tuning in to Dear Cyber Sue. I'm Susan McCord. Today I want to answer a question that I discussed on the platform Quora, which I write for quite regularly. I found it a really interesting question because it is a lot of people have been sort of commenting on it and viewing it, because whether it's happened to them, they know somebody it's happened to, but it is a question that gained some interest, so I wanted to bring it to the show today. So the question is, I broke up with my boyfriend after he cheated on me and blocked him after he found a new girlfriend. After a year, he contacted me and I ignored him. So now he blames me for missing an opportunity to be with a person who totally loves me. What should I do? So you did the right thing initially when this all happened. You respected yourself and you shut the door. You said, I deserve more than this. I have these boundaries. This guy stepped over the boundaries and left me sitting here to pick up the pieces of my broken heart. And now he comes back in wanting to start over as if nothing even transpired. He doesn't even have any remorse really about what happened. He's blaming you and trying to manipulate the situation so that you will come back to him. So be proud of yourself for the boundaries that you had. This is really good. A lot of people will get stuck in this situation, but I really loved him. He really loved me. Oh, maybe he'll change. Maybe this will, you know, he needed to do this to get it out of his system. Whatever people make excuses about. You knew this was wrong for you. Please don't second guess yourself and try to talk yourself back into it, because he's making you feel like you're missing out on the perfect guy. Well, we all know that that's a big facade, because he would have come back very quickly if he had made a huge mistake in the beginning. He barely apologized to you and he walked out into another scenario with somebody else for a year. Most people don't change that much. They can change a little bit and you can learn to forgive them, but it doesn't mean you have to go back for more of the same. And a lot of people do this because they think, oh, they really do love me. Oh, they came back to me. They came back to you, but a long time later. And this is the problem with this kind of a situation. There wasn't a lot of, you know, knocking on the front door and trying to get your attention and win your heart back because they felt so terrible. They went on to another relationship and didn't give it a second thought. That's where your mindset should be. And it's not a horrible thing to take that on, because we all have stuff like this. We all have things that we have to learn from. And the quicker that you can learn from a situation, like a relationship that just didn't honor you, then you can move on and find a better relationship down the road. Until you get that about yourself and understand why you choose some of your behavioral stuff, you will continue to stay stuck. It sounds to me, though, like you have done the right thing here. But the only thing that you're doing that I sort of question is that you are questioning your initial actions with this guy. Don't do that. You know, your instincts know, the reason you blocked him was because you knew. This guy is not worth my energy, he's not worth my love and my heart. So please think about it. If he's really done some major homework and changed and gone for therapy and all that stuff, well, everybody deserves forgiveness to a certain degree. But it sounds like the fact that he's sort of trying to blame you for it kind of shows that he hasn't really learned a lot here. You have, though. You've learned what's important to you and how much you deserve in your life, and that you don't have to put up with people who don't treat you well. So kudos to you. So thanks for tuning in once again to Dear Cyber Sue, and please subscribe if you haven't already done so, and leave any comments you have or any show topic ideas you'd like me to do, or if you have a question, an advice question that you would like me to answer on the show, I'd be more than happy to do so. Thanks everyone. Have a great day. Bye-bye.